We want to graph the linear inequality x minus 4y is less than 4. The graph of this is going to consist of a half plane that contains all the points with ordered pairs that would satisfy this inequality. To do this, we have two steps. We'll first graph the borderline, and the second step will be to determine on which side of the line contains all of the solutions in which we'll shade. So the first step is to treat this as if it was a line with the equation x minus 4y equals 4. And this is called the borderline. But before we graph this line, we need to take a look at the original inequality symbol. Notice that it's less than. And because it's less than or greater than, we're going to make a dashed line, not a solid line. The dashed line means the line is not going to be part of the solution. If we had a less than or equal to or greater than or equal to inequality symbol, we would make a solid line because the line would be part of the solution. So we can't forget this has to be a dashed line. Now the next step, we need to graph this line. Now this line is in standard form. So there's a couple of ways to graph it. We could solve it for y and put it in slope-intercept form. But one way that's often convenient to graph a line in slope-intercept form is to graph the line using the x and y intercepts. So to find the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0. And to find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0. So if we complete this table, it'll provide us with two points on the line, and then we can graph the line. Of course, we can use other values of x and y to complete this table, but these are often convenient. For example, if y is equal to 0, notice how we just have the equation x equals 4. And if x is equal to 0, we would have 0 minus 4y equals 4, or just negative 4y equals 4. So we divide by negative 4, and we have y equals negative 1. And now we can plot these two points and sketch our borderline. But again, remember, it is going to be dashed. So the point 4, 0 is here, and the point 0, negative 1 is here. So our line passes through these two points, but is dashed. So it would look something like this. And now we need to figure out whether we're going to shade above the line or below the line. And because this is not solved for y, to be safe, let's use a test point. And the easiest point to test is the origin, as long as the line does not pass through the origin. So we'll test this point here, and if it satisfies the inequality, we'll shade the same side that we're on. And if it does not satisfy the inequality, we'll shade the other side. So we're going to test the inequality using the ordered pair 0, 0. So if we have x minus 4y is less than 4, and we're substituting 0 for x and 0 for y, we have 0 is less than 4. Well, 0 is less than 4, so this is true, which means we're on the side of the line that we need to shade. So this half plane above the line contains all the points with the ordered pairs that would satisfy the given inequality. So this would be the graph of our inequality. I hope this was helpful.